Hey everyone, it's Dark Knight Admin. Today we're back with Admin Prep. We're talking about productivity and collaboration. In this section, we're going to cover productivity and collaboration at 7%. We're going to describe the capabilities of Activity Management, Chatter, Salesforce Mobile, and AppExchange. So what is Activity Management? These are your tasks and events. Tasks are typically to log a call, send an email, reminder for a follow-up. Events, these are typically meetings. They can be tied to more than one person. Managers will look at activities to see how well people are doing things. Users will use them to close deals and cases. And there's also on the homepage, you have the homepage reminders, which are today's events and today's task. These are some of the activity settings. These all need to be enabled if you want to use them. If an event is selected as all day, the start and end time are both grayed out. So this one thing to note, if it's an all day event, the start and end time are going to be grayed out because it's all day event. But some of the other ones you may want to look at enabling group tasks. If you want to assign a task to a group, you can enable that functionality. If you want to enable multi-day events, you can enable that there. You can also enable email activity reminders. You can also enable the creation of recurring tasks. These are all things you can turn on if you want your users to be more productive. There is a public calendar. This allows you to share activities with others. Allows others to see what calendars you have. You can also control whether or not they can see your calendar. So you can put your calendar for others to see. You can also control what they can see on your calendar. The Chatter application is typically used for collaboration. You can add mention users with this. There's a Chatter tab that allows you to chat, shows whatever you have access to in your chat. It can be used, you have groups if you have access to, you can be used on records, it can be used in the feed, providing that you have access to all those things. With Chatter, you can also post polls, ask questions, post links. Those are some of the cool things you can do with Chatter. You can also just write basic comments. Within Chatter, there's also Chatter Streams, which allow you to make a feed for things that you just want to follow. This is in addition to just your normal Chatter feed. A Chatter Stream is you're gonna specify the types of records that you want to follow in order to those things in that stream. So any Chatter messages that are tied to these records are gonna be in that particular stream for that. So if you wanted to create a stream that's for company ABCD, and you can put all the companies and the case records for that particular company in there, those would all be followed in there. Just a reminder, Chatter Streams is only available in Lightning. Chatter groups are a great way to allow like-minded people to collaborate in things. Groups can be public or private. Public groups can be seen by all. Private groups can only be seen by the people within those groups. There is an option for broadcast only, which means that only the owner of the group can post messages. So that means that most of the times when you have a group, you can have that collaboration back and forth. If you want to create a broadcast only group, you can check that box right here and allows that only the owner to post messages into that group. So this is typically seen as like a company announcement page. You just want to have announcements be sent out, but you don't want a lot of people responding to things. You can post the messages like this. On the record page, there is the activity and there's the chatter. With the activities, it's showing your activities. So if the record is related to a task or event, it's going to be shown in here. And your actions, if they are a email task or if they're just a task or an event, they're going to show in here. And then you also have your chatter option here, which is going to show that post, poll, and question, where you can post a poll, post a question, or just make a post. So Slack is another thing that may show up on the test. It's not in the guide, but we're just going to quick talk about it just in case it's there. Slack is used for collaboration, and it can integrate into Salesforce. A lot of times you may run into issue and on an opportunity, you want to have a collaboration session, you may want to post that message into Slack, and then you can have a Slack channel work on those responses within that group. Before we move on, please like, share, and subscribe. I do produce Salesforce tips every week. So on the mobile side, there are some benefits to it. You can collaborate instantly. You can pull up sales figures with a tap. You can organize your day. You can see urgent messages. You can find everything faster. You can close your deals faster because it's all at your fingertips on your mobile app. On your mobile app, there's a couple of things called buttons on here. They're called quick actions. These are going to be just like your actions that you use in normal Salesforce, but these are dedicated to your mobile device and they'll do certain things. The show more, just be mindful of that. That is where you can also do things like upload photos and add new tasks and things of that nature. So quick actions are going to show up in order for your users to have clickable things and clickable actions within the mobile app. If you want to change the layout, you can do your complex layout. You can have up to 10 fields, and you can also assign your layout to the different profiles. Just shows the different fields that are going to show for that particular layout when you look at that particular record. Within mobile navigation, you have your different apps. So you didn't do your different navigation items. You can select them, which ones you want to show there. These are kind of related to your apps in here, all the different headers and tabs that are there. You're going to take those and they're going to be shown in here just like that. So that's how that works. And then the AppExchange. These are where you have pre-built solutions. We can have things like pre-built reports and dashboards, accounting systems, CTI adapters, document generation. All these types of things are going to be pre-built solutions that you want to do. On the test, if you're looking to solve a particular issue and it's a commonly occurring issue, you probably use the AppExchange or an AppExchange product to do those types of things. Thanks for coming, and I'll see you next time.